serve one.
Last match of the day session here then in the Infinity Arena in Frankfurt. Nicholas Lum here, world number 35, 18 years of age. Continental standout in his career. That's why his ranking is up. He's directly entered, but he's got a very tough opponent here in Lim Jong-hoon, top 20 start from Korea Republic. He's just so strong, so solid. A little heavyweight presence about Lim whenever he's at the table. But young man is a shot maker as well.
Well, they both have an incredibly strong base. You can see the definition in the legs. But Lim, another beast from the Far East, as you quite rightly say, in that same kind of weight class as Dapon Big Fatty Liang Jingquin, as he's known. Belovedly by the Chinese fans, of course.
Two, three.
Lim is an incredible flicker of the ball. He can get on the front foot straight away with that receive. So Nicholas Lum will have to try and suffocate that straight from the serve.
Left, two, three.
It's one of the reasons why Lim and Shin are top three in the world in mixed doubles.
Left, two, three.
Well, they just combine so well. Yeah. Those strengths that complement each other.
Four,
straight
two.
Back at Lum. It's a good start there. Four of the first 6 points for Lim, but for Lum here, this is just such an... for everyone, as I say, it is. It's a big opportunity. But for him, where he's at... Oh, he doesn't need that, does he, from Lim? Ridiculous net cord there.
A dribbler.
Three, five.
For Lum as well, actually. I saw quite a bit of him about a year ago, commentated the Commonwealth Games. He had a very good games.
Four, five.
I saw he had quality there. But I come back to the point I was making to you, Fraser, before, that you still think of him as this kind of younger talent. You know, you're used to at WTT champions level. You know, these players are extremely well established. They've got titles, everything else, big titles.
Five,
he doesn't have that yet, but what he's got is he's got ability and he's fully fit now. Had a bad back injury after those good performances in Birmingham at the Commonwealths. And you know, you often say, if you've got a bad injury like that, how long it takes you to come back and be 100% again?
Six, five.
Well, in the modern era, it takes less time, but still, it's so tough to come back. Mentally as well, you might be a little bit ginger in your movement, a little bit wary that it's going to come back again if you exert yourself too much.
Can't pick that up below the height of the table there, and Lim through to the second towel break, leading by two again.
They both have extremely physically taxing styles. Why it's rare to see an out-and-out aggressor play beyond the age of around 30.
Six, seven.
Beautifully done, how he picked that up. And maybe why you would say... It can be different reasons, but with the back injury as well, such a physical style when you're only, at that point, 17, 18 years of age. You know, not finished growing at that point.
Eight, six.
He's got that ridiculous net, and now I think he's got a back edge as well.
Yeah, after that gorgeous grease from Lum, that is just going to be nothing but insult to injury.
Nine, six.
He's done all right this game, Nicholas Lum. However, Lim is going to get more used to this style and the spin coming in. You should get a different kind of quality off each opponent.
6-10.
There, look at the length on that, the bat breaker. We see people get injured trying to go for shots like that. Christian Carlsen and Haramoto have cut their hand open trying to go for loops off a half long.
11-6.
Game got away game from Lim in the end after a bright start. See if he can start game two as well as he did the first.
One.
Struck that beautifully. Curled the wrist back. Timed it wonderfully. Low posture. Giving Lim Jong-hoon a taste of his own medicine.
Left. Love one. Left. Love, one.
His fundamentals are very good. You can't really fault the technique of Nicholas Lund.
Right. Two, love.
Wait.
Lund plays his league table tennis, Oeschenhausen. About the German Bundesliga.
Three,
over the table there. I mean, that's something that, Lim's compatriot Lee Sang-soo would have liked that in terms of right hand over the table. That's brilliant.
Yeah.
Perfect play.
1-3.
Lim with his flick is doing different things. There's the top spin one, and there's the one that has a little bit more side spin. He contacted that one slightly more centrally, so less top spin than Nicholas Lund thought there was.
1-4.
He's acquitting himself well here, Lund. Saw it early in the first game here, 4 of the first 5 in game 2.
4-2.
Through to the towel break, despite that. He leads by a couple here. There's a lot of chat, isn't there, Fraser, about that, about the ranking? Okay, you've had that injury, 18 years of age. Whether it helps to be ranked? I mean, he is where he is because of his continental performances, yeah. Oceania performances. But 35 in the rankings. You know, whether that's a good thing? I guess you just make the argument this sort of opportunity. He's going to fast-track you, potentially. I mean, there's the potential to do that.
He's going to have to start taking advantage of the fact that he's placed very nicely, often straight into the main draw of big events. Yes, being from a country like Brazil or Australia allows you to get a lot of points that you might not be able to do if you weren't from those places.
Three,
we're not going to comment on that, because no matter where you're from, no matter which continent you play in, you deserve that. Being the king of your continent, you deserve that. Heavy weighting, if you can go far in continental events. But I feel like he will be surpassed if he doesn't start getting through the initial rounds.
4-5.
He will be able to use his ranking as leverage, though, to get better training in certain areas. And I think moving to Germany is a sensible decision.
5-0.
Germany is the, you know, main hub of Europe in many senses, with clubs like Dusseldorf, Starbuck, and Oeschenhausen.
Such a good push there from Lim. Takes the lead here for the first time in this second game.
Seven-5.
They trailed by 4, didn't they? One point here. Now leading by 2, turning it round. 7-5. Just underlining that 6 of the last 8 points now for Lim Jong-hoon.
8-5.
So slow, so much rotation there. Nicholas Lund trying to play the captain hook forehand, come round the side of it. That would have been gorgeous.
5-9.
Very hard to execute, though.
And continuing here for Lim. Of course, he never really got flustered being behind early in the game.
Left. 5-9.
Why would he? Ranked and as experienced as he is.
6-9. 9-7.
Over the table again. He's shown some quality. You talked about him having good fundamentals. He's had some good shot executions from the Australian.
Yeah. High and shallow. Made it easy for him to come over, but still. Very well done.
10-7.
It's all about the fundamentals, the average level, the middle ground.
11-7.
That's where Lim is.
Game to Lim.
Running a Macau rematch, and the winner of this plays the winner of that.
One love.
things you wanted to know about what Nicholas Lunn is coming into here, this WTT Champions Frankfurt. That section of the draw you've just talked about, highlighted, tells you everything you need to know about the stacked quality.
Love two.
He's certainly shown here, he's two down, but you know, he's starting very well again. He's started the games very well. Just hasn't quite been able to pull it through. It's gone on.
Left, love two.
Yeah.
One, two.
I mean, it's like he doesn't look, he's really trying that hard there, Lim Jong-hun. I mean, he's absolutely nailed that.
Well, this is the thing, if you try too hard, you'll probably miss. You've got to stay loose.
Three,
that's where the speed comes from, and we saw it there on that winner from Lum. Oh, the serve was lovely.
Two.
Long and back spinny. Stepped around straight away, knew Lim was going to try and spin. Maybe just went slightly too big.
2-4.
But you're right, Guy, he has got off to a good start in you know, most of the games. Maybe shows that he's maybe stopped and thought about it a little bit too much.
Mm. Well, see where he sticks with it here, can stick onto the lead this time.
Five.
Shake of the head from Lim. This is where he made that recovery in game two. In this sort of position in the scoreline.
5-3.
But still, you can't help but admire the physicality of Lim Jong-hoon on these balls here. From his left leg through to his right.
4-6.
Pulled there by the serve, though. Subtle change. Imparted some topspin on it.
4-7.
Well played, young man.
Look how low he gets.
Seven, five.
That was laced.
This is the annoying thing about table tennis sometimes. How you can play a point like that and then miss a serve. Goes to show how much you have to be constantly open-minded and relaxed enough to know when you have to adapt and how you need to adapt. Also, how you need to make your opponent adapt. So there's so many things to think about.
Left, 7-5.
The irony of it is often the more you think about it, the harder it is to play. You've got to kind of let all the training speak for itself.
8-5.
Another one. He has produced some quality moments here, Lum. Another one to add to the learning experience.
He's leant back as he's played that with the racket finishing above the head. Miracle.
6-8.
So maybe the two here for Lum. He's done a much better job of, we're now getting into the back end of the game, still leading.
Nice.
Swats that away. The Aussie to put the lead back up to three.
Well, for a player that lost in the round of 64 at the Singapore Smash to Koh and Pang, this is much improved here from Nicholas Lum.
10-6.
A little bit stunned here, Lim, with this run from Lum. Four game points.
Left, 10-6. Ten, seven.
And the serve. Three more game points for Lund.
Thank goodness,
Lim misses out on the receipt.
Love all.
WTT Champions level debutant Nicholas Lum here. Trading now 2-1.
One love.
That's a pretty special way there to begin game four. Lim Jong-hoon here, still in front. Just gets the edge there, sending that through.
Nice fade, albeit.
Well,
you know, to get a game against one of the hardest hitters and coldest spitters in the world of table tennis, three-time world championship medalist Lim Jong-hoon, is a victory in itself for Nicholas Lum. What I'm thinking here is, Guy, does he kind of get too happy with that and become complacent, or does he build on that and just kind of press the reset button?
Change the outcome in this fourth game. Immediately.
It's a horrible feeling being 2-0 up and your opponent gets a game back. You do not want it to go to a fifth. Lim playing with more intensity here.
It was just the way he strode back out, I think, after, as you say, the way he started pre the timeout, those first 3 points. There's no interest in going to a fifth.
No.
And
that kind of underlines it. He's just keen to get this done as quickly as he can. He's running away now.
It's poetry in motion. The sweep of that. I mean, Lum winning that game was like a red rag to a bull.
One, six.
Oh, yeah. Nicely done. Flight of that service there. And the pitch of it as well.
No spin on it, and Lim tried to do a dummy loop. Fresh aired it.
6-3.
3 points in a row.
He had a fantastic run in Xingshan, Lim, you know, where he nearly beat Fan Zhendong. Lost in seven after beating Tomokazu Hadamoto, but he would love to get more success in singles, I feel.
3-7.
It's funny, he's put that into there, but I mean, that's a great pickup, isn't it, from Lim as well. You think where he is relative to the table, the feeling.
Gorgeous.
Yeah, a lot of the focus is on the guy's miss there, but you've got to think why.
Yeah, no, it was great intricacy, wasn't it?
Four, seven.
Oh, Limwick, yeah, Lim's nodding there. He would have liked that one himself.
Really hard to play the white of the line there.
8-4.
The big problem here for Lum is just the fact that he fell those 3-4 points adrift immediately. And it's tough at this level. We talk about the learning experience where he's at in his young career. Any sorts of dips, you've been alluding to it, they get punished by these top players.
9-4.
The top players are the players who are best at playing each point on its own merit. It's so much easier said than done.
4-10.
There and waiting. And he's waiting for the round of 16 here. Shouldn't have to wait too long for it now. Lim Jong-hoon fizzes that through. 6 match points.
5-10.
It's all over.
Game match.
Entertaining encounter that to conclude the day session. Lim Jong-hoon.